Hey guys, welcome back. Political violence, okay, and a little talking. Well, here's something that got us through the last round of political violence in 2020. I live in the Seattle area. We experienced it. Pick up a couple of these. These really helped us out last time because when the radicals move into your area, the first thing they do is they cut power. Yeah, they do. I've been through it. I know. And they usually use chainsaws and start cutting down the wooden telephone poles or the wooden power poles. That's how they knock your power out and other means. It happened to us. We've already been through it. But know, first of all, that you cannot control the actions and thoughts of other people. You can't. And if you think you can, seek help. Okay? So what can I control that's inside of my little box? Just my little world right here. I can make sure that we've got light, we've got a way of cooking, and a way of staying warm. So today I'm going to top off some of these little 1 pound propane bottles. I got a full size bottle here. Make sure you're in the frame. Let me get this adjusted just a bit. And I'll show you this adapter that I bought. Pretty simple thing to use. This is the adapter right here, like 10 or 12 bucks. Threads right onto these large size bottles. And there is a little bit of gas escapes when you're refilling these 1 pound bottles. So I just got the garage door open and make sure that everything's up to go. You know, no open flames. But anyway, all you got to do to top these little one pound tanks off, and you can see that I've got more than a few because that's part of my preparedness, is having quite a few of everything on hand. Turn it over, since propane is a liquid. Lift it up and open the valve. Open the valve on the bottle and it starts to fill. Normally you can hear some hissing because you can hear it rushing inside of the 1 pound bottle. I'm just topping these off because, here we go, let's open that all the way up. Now, I don't do all the weighing and the freezer and all the other stuff. I just make sure that we've got this thing full. So this thing is already telling me that it's full. And then I just go ahead and unthread it. There'll be a little bit of gas escape. But these are some of the things that I can control to make sure that we've got light, we've got a way of cooking, all that. I can't control what the radicals are going to do. And you saw just the other day, yeah, we had another example of political violence when the Don got shot. Think of things like this and act on it. You can do some of this stuff. You guys can do this. This is easy to do. I'm just going to show you how simple it is. You just got to spend a little bit of time and control and do what you can control. There we go. That one needs a refill for sure. I can hear it hissing, so that means it's refilling it right now. Things like this. There's another thing that you can do is top off your bottles, make sure that you've got some candles and the different ways of cooking. That's really important because if you're still going to want to have to eat. And you want to have hot food. And I'll tell you my experience in 2020 when they cut the power here. It was off for 3 days and nights. And my wife and son are healthcare providers and they can't take time off. They have to go to work. And they were prepared to take the car trip. And I sat at home with my teenage daughter. And it was just she and I on our own. And we cooked with propane and all that. And I checked in with the family regularly, make sure they're all right. They let me know when they were on their way home. And home, that's one thing that you want to be sure to do. Well, I noticed that during all of the political violence in 2020, that most people did the smartest thing is they stayed home, if they possibly could. But healthcare providers and first responders, they can't. They have to go to work. A little bit of gas escape, but the door is open and we're all good. I just fill these up until I can hear it stop hissing. This one's a little bit of work to do on it. Just take a second. But yeah, I'm going to go right back to it again. What's inside your box, what's inside of your home, you can control. So put some good use to your spare time. That's all I can really tell you guys. You can only control about what you do. You can't control what's going on outside of you and your home. The only thing that I can do extra is vote and sign petitions, and I do. And I urge you to vote. There we go, we got it open. This one's refilling right now. But yeah, think of the little stuff like this that'll make things easier. Because when it was just my teenage daughter and I, she would come downstairs from her room and she would get lots of glasses of water, and she was silent. And I knew that she was upset, you know. And she would be texting her friends back and forth, and I'd ask her what's the latest with her friends in the different small towns. Everything seemed to be okay, but then once in a while she'd have to go recharge her phone. I'd pull up a lawn chair in front of the car while she plugged in her phone and recharged it. And I'd stood guard over her while she was recharging her phone. I never left her side. I had food and water in the house, and we never had to go outside the house. Not even once. Just stayed right there in the home, in the house. And I'll say it again, when political violence kicks off again, and it will, I mean, look what happened just the other day. Stay inside your house. Have extra medicine and food and water ready so you don't have to leave. I'll just go over the basics of this video again. Political violence is going to come. Take care of what you can. Little stuff like this makes a big difference when the lights go out, and that's the first thing they do. Thanks for watching.